Hi guys, today I want to talk about one of the most important questions, and this is how much money would you need to bring here to Canada? Why in general you need to bring some money here? When you come in here as a newcomer, as a new immigrant, you may face some expenses, and sometimes people are not ready for these expenses, although we're trying to show you the different aspects of life here in Canada. We're trying to show you how much money you need to spend for this and that and that. Of course, it's very hard to say in general because every situation is different, every family is different, but for some people that might be a huge surprise when they come in here and they out of nowhere they need to get a lot of money and pay rent, and rent is, you know, it's getting more expensive here, and especially in Ontario, and people getting shocked, and they like, oh, why we have to pay $2,000 a month? Where are we going to get money? We don't even have a work. We were trying to get some education, so get some courses. So to reduce amount of stress that you may face here, our government comes out with this amounts of money that you need to bring here. So in this case, you won't be stressed about food, about your place where you're going to live. And by the way, this is very interesting. When you come in here as a newcomer, you don't have your credit information, you don't have you're not employed yet, so of course you don't have employment letter and guarantees, so you have nothing to prove your income. And for newcomers, usually they have to pay for 6 months or even for 1 year ahead of rent. So can you imagine if you come in here where rent is about $2,000 or $2,500 a month, then you need to pay for even 6 months ahead, so it's $12,000 already with minimum expenses. Of course, you can find maybe cheaper if you have a smaller family, but we're talking about like average family right now that come in here. So in this case, you might face a lot of expenses that you didn't expect. So you must show that you have enough money to settle in Canada when you come in here through Federal Skill Worker Program and Federal Skill Trades Program, and Express Entry included in this. So depending on number of family members, you would need certain amount of money. So if you come in here alone, you would need $12,475. If you have two people in your family, you would need to bring $15,531. If you have three members in your family, you would need $19,093. It's almost $20,000. If you have a four, which is average family, two adults and two kids, you would need to bring $23,181. If you have five members of your family, it's going to be $26,292. Of course, you can bring more, but not less. If you have six members in your family, you would need to bring almost 30,000, which is $29,652 exactly. If you have seven members, which is very large family obviously, you would need to bring $33,014. And for each additional family member, you would need to have and prove $3,361. So technically, these funds must be available for you, and you would need to provide certain documents to prove this that you have this money, and it could be a letter from your bank with their official information, with on letterhead of course, with proper signatures, with your name, your bank account number, and with your balance, and they should disclose your balance for last 6 months. So it should be as many details as you can provide, especially your debt, if you have some credit cards information, if you have some investment accounts, or if you have any other sources of income, you can show it and you can prove that you would have enough money to bring here. I hope this information was very interesting for you, and don't forget to subscribe and ask me some questions. Bye now!